Oh, hello everyone. I'm going to read my paper to keep in time. This paper discusses the conceptual underpinnings, working processes, and the tools used for preparing the scene files of a holographic artwork for this exhibition at this ISDH, which offers a subjective viewpoint on the idea of homeland. The artwork Homeland is an optically formed fringe digital hologram, which is contextualized by the holographic maps used in situational awareness, and it indicates its subjectivity by strongly referencing the human body, particularly the lines of the palm of the hand. I have to read the caption, which is cut off the bottom of this image. Zebra imaging liaison officer briefs soldiers on the capabilities of tactical digital holograms. Soldiers deployed to Iraq and Afghanistan have been using TDH since the inception of the Tactical Battlefield Visualization Program in 2006. Copyright Zebra Imaging, Inc. Do not use without written permission. As a background, the military applications of technologies have long been a part of the discourse of art practice engaged with these technologies. But until recently, such issues of military agency were not applicable to the field of holography. Now it's widely known that holograms are playing a role in homeland security. A recent article in the Army Times states, "This three-dimensional representation of complex urban, non-urban terrain, subterranean bunkers and other combat and non-combat environments aids the warfighter through providing high-resolution 3D battlefield infrastructure intelligence. This is critical for planning and executing combat and non-combat operations." According to Lynn Schnoe, the Army Intelligence Chief Information Officer and Director of the Intelligence Community's Information Management Directorate, so far, about 12,000 holographic images have been sent to soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan. Any unit preparing to deploy can ask for one to be custom made for its area of operations. Run by the Army Deputy Chief of Staff for Intelligence, the Tactical Battlefield Visualization Program provides soldiers with these holograms made by Zebra Imaging in Austin, Texas. Conceptual underpinning. Dora Appel's article, "Technologies of War, Media and Dissent in the Post-9/11 Work of Christoph Fedechko, 2008, provides a view of some of Christoph Fedechko's artistic works which engage with the idea of homeland. And I quote, "In addition to its formal intertwining with media technology, the multiple environments of Fedechko's installation demonstrate the infiltration of war technology through the trope of surveillance. Conceptually, the project addresses the effects of contemporary war culture and the incursion of the heightened power of the state into every kind of domestic or homeland space, creating a perpetual state of hypervigilance in which the homeland is always ready, mobilized for war. If military technology can be domesticated, the domestic also becomes militarized." These ideas about homeland provide a framing context for the overarching experience of viewing Christoph Fedechko's work, which is in fact one of deep empathy and compassion for all people. Such an experience of empathy and care is also the objective of my homeland art project. The Homeland Art Project puts on display in a museum or art gallery the way of looking associated with holographic tactical battle visualization in order to propose homeland as a personal subjective domain. This is accomplished by shifting the area of operation to the space and time of human life. The Homeland Art Project image was made using the same technology and is displayed in the gallery with a bunker purpose designed rugged grasshopper lighting stand with rotating turntable used by the military to closely examine holographic images. As the Army Times article states, using these holograms, soldiers can improve their understanding, retention, and situational awareness of the areas of operations. Leaders reporting they used holograms to better analyse, assess and determine different courses of actions. Inviting this very keen awareness in the art gallery viewer, the project visualises homeland as the terrain of traces of the hands of many humans. In a phenomenological sense, this visualisation suggests homeland to be the traces of life registered in the fabric of the body. In the words of the philosopher Maurice Merleau-Ponty, the thickness of the body, far from rivaling that of the world, is on the contrary the sole means I have to go into the heart of things by making myself a world and by making them flesh. The process in pictorial agency of the work. The base ground of homeland art project image is green and looks similar to the military terrain holograms, which are monochrome green. However, there are significant differences. The terrain of the homeland art project is made in an entirely different way, from an aggregate of lands which were formed by directly casting into the palms of several people's hands who were asked to imagine they were holding a piece of light. These positive shapes with their complex organic ridges and valleys are the materialised form of an invisible place, a personal and subjective homeland which people carry with them every day. In contrast to the significant reduction in scale and resolution of terrain elements in the military holograms, sufficient palm casts were made to cover the 60 by 60 centimetre area to enable all of them to appear life-size. Each silicone cast was photographed and made into a 3D form using the Agisoft PhotoScan software, and then these forms were assembled in Maya. The prominent spatially positive path of the lifeline is obvious on each of these casts. The lifeline is unique in the repertory of lines encountered in the world, inasmuch as it does not denote a physical edge or a boundary of a three-dimensional form. Rather, it is a body marking which is integral to the body. Its contours and length have a questionable but long-established association with life prediction, potential and mortality. Apart from the terrain itself, sometimes for clearer military pre-visualisation, two-dimensional lines drawn onto acetate are sometimes overlaid on the hologram to indicate approach paths. Obviously, when drawing in two dimensions, certain types of notation for spatial representation can be used, such as creating a line to form the boundary of a space or using projection systems such as perspective. But of course, once lines appear in three-dimensional space, these techniques are no longer appropriate. So this is because as the viewer moves, the mobility of their line of sight makes available numerous possibilities of composition from the 3D line relationships. And as Emma Dexter writes in her introductory essay to Vitamin D, New Perspectives in Drawing, drawing exists at another level within the human psyche. It is a locus for signs by which we map the physical world, but it is in fact the preeminent sign of being. Therefore, drawing is not a window on the world, but a device for understanding our place in the universe. Hand-drawn line is used in Homeland Art Project to trace the potent subject of the lifeline. Using the haptic phantom interface and Holoshop software, lines were drawn by feeling the paths of the lifelines on three-dimensional templates made from the palm casts. A major pictorial objective of Holoshop is the assignment of appropriate visual characteristics to gestures. The phantom device is used to capture the gestures made by the artist. It is a haptic device which allows a user to import three-dimensional spatial movements using a pen-like grip. The grip is attached to a mechanical arm with 6 degrees of freedom, hence it's capable of recording all 3D movements of the user. The device is also capable of generating a synthetic force field based on the computer-generated 3D graphics. Various types of synthetic force fields, such as magnetic field, can be programmably generated based on 3D geometries. For artists to fully express their 3D spatial movement using this device, the holographic software needs to be able to capture various physical characteristics of those movements through adjusting the Phantom device's mechanical parameters. They are angular and linear tolerance, force stiffness, and damping parameters. These parameters will determine the physical response of the Phantom device when it interacts with 3D virtual objects. Those parameters also influence how much detail of artist's movement is captured. Hence, these parameters serve two purposes. Firstly, adjusting the level of detail of the artist's movement, and secondly, adjusting the tactile feedback. While these parameters, which are directly associated with the Phantom device, play a certain role in determining the range of expression lines can convey, there are other factors which have significant impact on how artists' movement is expressed. And they are firstly an encoding method of the speed of the artist's hand, and secondly computational constraints applied to the movement of the Phantom device itself. In velocity mode, in order to truthfully capture the characteristics expressed in the form of speed of the artist's hand, Holoshop software has implemented methods to control the thickness or the width of the drawn line depending on the speed of the hand movement. This method transforms a velocity value of the device into width of a line using a sigmoid function whose minimum and maximum values correspond to the minimum and maximum widths of the line. The normal velocity mode will apply a normal sigmoid function to the velocity so that the faster the speed of the movement, the thicker the line becomes. And we also have what we call reverse velocity mode, which allows the user to produce a thicker line when the speed is slow and a thinner line when the speed is fast. Magnetism mode is another factor which significantly influences how the artist can effectively work in the 3D environment. And it gives a provision for spatial constraint on the haptic device. Without any spatial constraints, an artist will be able to move the device very freely in space to draw lines. However, if the lines need to be drawn with respect to other geometries in the same space, having the 6 degrees of freedom often actually provides too much free movement. So this usually results in the user not being able to have total control in determining the location of the haptic device in the 3D space. So in order to reduce this inconvenience, Holoshop software exploited the virtual magnetic field to constrain the movement of the haptic device. When this virtual magnetic field is turned on, the space where the tip of the haptic grip can move is restricted to nearby surfaces, and this function is particularly useful if the movements of the artist's hand need to be guided by the underlying geometry template. With the provision of these parameter controls and different line drawing modes to capture the spatial movement of the haptic device, the changes of momentum caused by the topography of the contours and the speed of the gesture were registered in the varying widths and orientations of lines. The lines in the homeland hologram are flat red ribbon-like, referring to the approach path planning lines, yet they strongly evidence the inflections from the change in direction and speed familiar from direct handmade marks. The red colour of the life lines is symbolic of the luminous presence of life. The lines were translated at varying heights above the lifeline templates from which they were formed, and when translated and viewed directly from above, it's possible to superimpose only one line at a time with its lifeline. As the viewer's line of sight changes, the amount and type of occlusion between lines at different levels obscure or open sections of the terrain. The depth of tactical battle visualization holograms is intentionally restricted to enable the subject matter to appear sharp. Generally, lines superimposed 2D on the hologram picture plane. The red 3D contoured lines of Homeland Art Project are translated at various distances from the holographic plate, so they range from sharp to blurred. And this is similar to the way in which the artist Jim Campbell has used low resolution in his work. In this work, the sliding scale of blur in Homeland art project acts as a metaphor for the distant in its objectification to be gradually dissolved into intangible softness and closeness. And just in for 1 second, I will show you this test will be up the back, you can see, but you can see that obviously hologram is quite, these are three lifelines superimposed over three test hands.
Yeah, the top.
Is that better? You can see the blurs quite noticeable.
That's got it.
Better? Yeah. So you can kind of see that you get a range of effects where the lines are dissolving out. Okay, I'll put it down. You can have a closer look at it later on. So, as the red Homeland lines become less opaque, the green background shows through, reminiscent of green underpainting, lending vibrancy to painted flesh. These dissolving, intertwining lines conflate the rational purpose of line as intention with the predictive association. These dissolving, intertwining lines conflate the rational purpose of line as intention with the predictive association of the lifeline and destiny, and invite the viewer to reach out and touch. As Diana Petherbridge notes in The Primacy of Drawing, Histories and Theories of Practice, the linear paths that the spectator interpreter directly perceives or infers in the drawing constitute cognitive mapping. And such readings are inseparable from the affective response to the gestural trace of the hand and the echo of the body, as well as the expressivity of the topic or subject matter of the drawing or its absence. The difference between these readings constitutes the surplus of the drawing within which meaning is constructed. And to conclude, the expressive potential of drawing is broadened by the availability of drawing tools which enable the freehand inscription of space with line. Holoshop software, which in conjunction with haptic interface Phantom Omni to feel virtual contoured surfaces, provides a means of using forces to modulate line quality through velocity, damping and friction. Future work in Holoshop will focus on expanding the scope and understanding of haptic handmade three-dimensional drawing for holograms and other three-dimensional displays. The use of Holoshop software and Zscape technology developed by Zebra Imaging enabled a subjective and personal visualization of Homeland, which unites people in an awareness of the mystery and precious nature of life. I would like to thank all the people involved.
Do we have questions for Paula?
Paula, how accessible is the haptic system, and how long does it take to get some comfort with it? I can't imagine that the drawing is sort of easily learned, or how did you feel about it?
Well, Sally, thank you for that question. It's my wish that it will be very simple for people to draw who've had no experience whatsoever, that it will be incredibly intuitive. And I'm happy to say that Masataka Tsuka's son, 5-year-old Charlie, came into the lab the week before I came over, and I asked him if he wanted to draw. We only have 5 colours, and we have a line that gets wide and narrow, or a straight line. And Charlie was actually able to grab the pen and draw little monsters with arms and I was altering the linear tolerance so he could do details with eyes, but I think by the time the project ends, which is another 3 years, I hope that we will have some really great tools for everybody to be able to create content.